ma tun gba ni ti re ma se ta kale mi re o jari ma tun gba ni ti re ma se ta kale mi re o jari bi a ba joyin bi a ba jado bi a ba fi tin wure je ka o pe ka ma gbagbe pe ati bo laje laye o bi a ba jiya bi a ba mu mi bi a ba mu mi oju la mu su o ka ma gba pepe ati bo laje laye o e da ye se ati gba o wi pe oja la wa na laye igba bana ja itan a o wa pada sodo olorun eni ranti iku e saye re eni ranti iku alopare o iku ni gbeyin gbogbo wa eniyan yo e ku kale o kasa ma kira wa ku pale morun ko seni ti o ni ku ko seni ti o ni lo gbogbo wa la dapada iku pese ti gbogbo wa je ni ere kini fe niyan to jere momo aye yi to sa mi ne ru na e ara mi esi o o ma se o fe ni ti o lo lorun ma se rora re ju bi o ti mo lo eniyan ma se rora re ju bi o ti mo lo eniyan ma se rora re ju bi o ti mo lo eniyan eru pe lasan to n ja to n mu ni neru pe to n si isa fi keru pe jo owo ti o ni eru pe ile ti o ko eru pe eru pe to je eru pe to je eru pe lo ti o pada de eru pe eniyan ma se rora re ju bi o ti
You gave us this day and we are thanking you for it. We thank you for his family, our captain, Ola Ibiroke. For his demise, we are burying him today. Father Lord, we thank you. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Today, Father Lord, let this be the last one that we have in this club. Protect us, God. Protect the family, his loved ones, his associates. We thank you for everything. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray.
Happy welcome.
So we need to honor him, and that is why we are here. And what happened this morning, party of peace, as well as ceremonial tea, we just one way of showing our respect, our honor, our love, and our affection for the good works that he has started. Because see, as you are coming, you see all the transformation around. Those are part of the good works that he has started, and that I will continue to live on even after him. So I welcome you all this morning to this great occasion. It's one of the memorial gifts, living legacies, lasting tributes that we can give to him, to show honor to him. That is what we are doing this morning, planting of trees and ceremonial tea in honor of our great captain. He's a great leader, great mentor, great father, great uncle, and great brother. So I welcome you all in the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Now, we have some of our members as part of our culture to talk freely about our late captain, Mr. Oladipo Iroke. I would like to call on Honorable Jerry Adeshio to please step forward to talk about our late captain.
Was a gentleman to the court. I was a late captain in 2015, and that was when I actually met him. I think after my captainship, I met him, and through some of his friends, Bani, mother, and he started referring to me as auntie. And I looked at this man, I'm like, he will probably be above my age mate or the year older, which he actually is. But he has so much respect for you. He respects people that much. Not only that, he's somebody that is approachable. I can approach him and tell him that this is what is happening. I think you should look into this. And immediately he will take action. If you see the course, somewhere is bad, and I tell him, Kapo, you have to look into this. This is, and he will take action almost immediately, call people to action, and that's it. I want to say that this is the kind of person he is. He's hardworking. And we had some time of chat for 12 before his limits. And I won't forget that. I just thank God for his life. Thank God that he has spent it to show that. I said, your son beat you to him. He said, yes, and I'll come and pay his party fee. And we also talk about that's who he is. That's beautiful. Thank you for me.
Over time, we still have quite a number of people that want to talk, but many things that way. Let me make it clear now that we will take response from any member of the family, Mr. Shewin Biroke. Then, after the response, we will sing our club anthem while we proceed to the banning of three. After that, we will do the ceremonial tea off. We will do everything once and for us so that we don't have to come back to this particular day. So now we have Mr. Shaw Ibiroken.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to say thank you for everyone being here. Thank you for us celebrating the life of the family. And I pray that the service of everything today goes well. American Jews, and thank you for being here. And thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Captain Mistala, you're my girl, okay? After the planting of the tree, all the lovers here present, we have tea off. Then afterwards, from here, from there, we will all meet for the church. We have plans to go and check for the church. Please, because of the time, let us proceed to the church. Sunday, all the members of the golf club.
This is symbolic planting of tree, usually done for our respected and departed colleagues. The last time we came here, I could see that we came here in honor of Prince Adeleke Festival, 3rd November 2020. I don't even know that I'm coming here for my honorable captain. This is a symbolic of life and respect we have for him. But that's why we are planting this tree. Just like we heard from testimony and tribute yesterday, Dudu is not dead. Dudu lives on. So as long as we keep seeing this tree, you remember the blue box. You see the green? You see the cost? You see the projects here, there? Even the fencing of this place, we contributed to develop this place so that we can be remembering our loved ones who have parted away. So he's a living legend. He's a hero. He's not dead already. He lives on. So when we see this tree, we remember Dudu, the good works, the living legacies. This is our memorial gift, living gift that we can give to him. And tree is life. And that's why we are doing this morning. So we are doing this to honor him in the name of God the Father, and the name of God the Son, and the name of God the
Holy Spirit.
So sleep on Kapu. Rest on Kapu. Your good work, listen. Your legacies, listen. And it speak volumes. Good works of you. In the name of God the Father and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. What does that for the family again? The children? Yes?
This one.
Oh, you're so funny.
Thank you all for witnessing this planting of trees. So our honorable captain lives on. And we all meet to see to each other on the resurrection day by the grace of the living God. So let's proceed down there, please.
Please come back, please come back. Come back, you have a zoom lens, come back.
Easy.
States. Power over there, and you have given us victory through the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. May your Holy Spirit remind us daily of our inheritance in your heavenly kingdom, so that we may not be overcome by the world and mix our fellowship with you in heaven, but keep our faith constant in your Son, who is the resurrection and the life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Thank you.
recorded by St. John. The 14th chapter, man's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may also be. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. This is the word of the Lord.
Together you elect in one communion and fellowship in the body of your Son Jesus Christ. Grant, we pray, you to give your own church in paradise and on earth your light and peace. Amen. Your joyful resurrection. Amen. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who live as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us into holiness and righteousness all the days of our lives. Amen. Grant to those who mourn, especially the family of Mr. Oladiran, Ishola Ibironke, assure confidence in your fatherly care, and are casting all their grief on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Amen. Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Amen. Thank you.
It is the word selflessness. Was selfless in his service to God and to humanity. To the golfing community, to his immediate and extended family members, to all who came across him. He was a selfless man. And we thank God for a life that has been well lived. It was the hymn that we rendered before this sermon. And I'm going to just say some few words. Only remembered by what we have done. And the charge for you and I is, what are you going to be remembered for when it comes to your own turn? So justification. And the challenge is for us, says militants, that one day it will be our own turn, when, how, where, we do not know. Thus we will pass from the earth and its toiling. Olugbala jagun molo ni ayo la o ma ko hallelujah. So from various walks of life, especially members of the famed quote and unquote Labe Igi Orombo Club, the Ibadan Golf Club, the home of golfing and hospitality for all sonners. We welcome very warmly all the dignitaries of the church, represented by our fathers in the Lord and our mother in the Lord, and to those who are peradventure seated here. We wholly welcome the dignitaries of the state and the society here present in this committal service of the earthly remains of our darling brother and friend, Dudu. Children, I sympathize and empathize with you on this great loss. Our prayer for you at this point in time is that genuine love, peace, unity, we reign supreme in your family in Jesus' name. More than ever, that cord of love God will use to bind you so that his legacy will continue to linger in our hearts in Jesus' name. You are true friends indeed. You lost a worthy person, your captain, who has been instrumental to all the wonderful renovations going on there. We are going to get there. And I'm going to charge you again. All of us, what are you using your time, your talents, your resources to achieve in life? We will get there later on. You have been involved in organizing the funeral arrangements right from that fateful day when Dudu went to be with the Lord, went to be his maker. And I specifically commend your spirit of loyalty, your sense of dedication, and the extension of your hands of fellowship. God knows you all, and as you start to be counted as friends in need, you are true friends in need. Praying for God's continued blessings upon you all. I know there is the Ola Ibiroke Funeral Support Platform. And permit me to mention just a few personal contacts who have contacted me about giving him a befitting burial. Brother TJ Otumba Bimbola Davis, Barrister Salami, the club manager Mr. Kola Ogunjobi, the executive committee, and many more. I pray that God will console you in the name of Jesus Christ. Succession in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known and from whom no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that he may worthily magnify your holy name and bless you. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Beloved people of God, the good book, our Bible, our constitution, our mantra, reminds us all that our time on earth is limited and as such must be accounted for at every point in time. In life, Dudu touched the souls of all who came in contact with him. And to those who had the service of songs yesterday and the night of tributes, and those who watched Paraventure online, we heard wonderful testimonies and tributes of the life and times of Dudu. A life of service and devotion to God and to humanity. Dudu had done his own bid and had been called up to give an account of his stewardship, just as each and every one of us will do when our own time is up. Hebrews 9 verse 27 is very, very apt to this statement. And as it is apt unto men once to die, but after that, the judgment. So it is left for that. Only those who have loved a loved one like Dudu will know the pain of parting without farewell. Parting without farewell. It was sudden, but we know that he is resting in the bosom of his Maker. We heard all those testimonies and tributes of his life and times. They were not a rent-a-crowd affair. There was one from an elderly member of this church and of the golf club. He said so very many things. The captaincy of Dudu was with a difference. Oh yeah, Tojo. It was with a difference. When you go there, Ibadan Golf Club, you will see what we are talking about. Not only that, it was pursued with zeal. His ideas were pursued with zeal. I cannot forget the 38th anniversary of Ibadan Golf Club. Ayegbo Orumo. He did wonderfully well. He handled everything. We cannot forget that. He was a proper Ijesha man. Not only that, we heard about humility, giving, not holding any grudge against anyone. He was transparent, full of life. But then, when death came, he had to go. The lesson from all we can glean from the service of songs and his passage is be prepared. That is the motto of the Boy Scout. Be prepared. Be prepared. Death is a private affair. A funeral like this is a public occasion, and grief is borne only by the immediate family and close friends. That little bond of bereaved clustered around the remains. And the liturgy is for a brief interval contained with the final separation that takes place when we get to the cemetery. That in all things we must give thanks. It is with that same belief that we raise our voices and hearts to give all thanks and praises to the Almighty with our relationship with Dudu. We thank God for the opportunity to have witnessed a genuine soul, a thoughtful and caring child of God, who has now gone forth to worship at heaven's gate. John 14, 1, 2, 3, especially, Jesus is assuring his disciples he was going to a place where they would ultimately go. When they die, they will find a place he has prepared for them. Do you want to be there too? Because I am going to be there. Ile baba mi opo ibugbe lo wa layo layo la o wa nibe layo layo la o wa nibe layo layo la o wa nibe ile baba. or her in the place as prepared for all believers. But while still alive, Jesus promised the Holy Spirit will continue to guide and comfort you. The Holy Spirit will grant you life. The Holy Spirit will grant you strength. He's your friend. He's your teacher. He's your guide. A life that fails to take death into account has a shallow lens that robs the owner of life's greatest victories. Listen, I sting and I ask, does one plan a trip without a finish line? And that is why I said earlier on, be prepared. We don't know who is next. Be prepared. It's friends and some people who gave the testimonies yesterday that if they will tell them in years to come that they will come and render the testifiers and be a testifier to his life and times, he will say it's a lie of the devil. Be prepared. Tertullian, a great church father, said it all, quoting, "It is a poor thing for anyone to fear which is inevitable." To fear which is inevitable. And how does one live to live a mature life without considering the inevitability of death? End of quote. Most deaths are unwanted. We don't want it. Most deaths are unplanned. Most deaths are unexpected. So we need to plan adequately and also prepare in advance for it. Whenever someone we love dies, we too die a little. When we grieve, when we are pained, when we are sorrowing, we know that we can never be exactly the same again. Our captain has just left without bidding us farewell. An area of life, a familiar voice, when he lumbers, when he comes around, when he organizes events and signs and does a lot of things, a familiar voice, that voice of his baritone, a footstep, a shared memory that will continue to linger in our hearts has suddenly disappeared and cannot ever be recreated. It is a heart-rending experience because the one we love and still loved and still love has a place in our hearts, and we can no longer find a place in it. A great violence has been done to us because we have lost the place we love to rest. So mixed with our sadness, there may be an anger. We are angry, angry, very, very angry that our husband, our father has gone to be with the Lord. The good Lord will continue to console you in Jesus' name. The Lord says, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. So Christ, in the second beatitude, lifts up the grieving, telling you to please take solace in this world. It is so hard to believe that God is no longer with us. He was very much part of our lives. Now we have our memories. All these little things he used, all those photographs, those souvenirs and pictures, only give a half image of a loved one. The pain and the real image are carried in the heart. As you gather here today, beloved people of God, we must remind ourselves that death is a very private thing. We cannot share sorrow with strangers. One red rose on the grave of Dudu speaks more than a shop full of bricks. A giving back to God, it is sacrifice. You are rendering a sacrifice. It is only the context of our Lord's passion and death that we can penetrate the mystery of suffering and understand the real meaning of the word sacrifice. We are called on to make so many sacrifices during our lifetime. For the loss of a dearly beloved one like Dudu is the supreme sacrifice. Only love can triumph over such a love. Listen to St. Paul in 1 Corinthians 13 verse 8. And in this moment of crisis, God is telling you that you must be tenacious in your faith. Tenacious. Because it is now you will not fear whether friends fair weather friends. We know who are your true friends. Glenn B. Kleser, a writer, has this to say about life. Quoting, "Your life is like a book. The title page is your name. The preface is your introduction to the world. The pages are a daily record of your efforts, fires, pleasures, and discouragements. Day by day, your thoughts and actions are being inscribed in your book of life. The record is being made that must stand for all time. One day the word by the French Sepinin must be written. Let it then be said, if you're in your book, that it is a record of noble purpose, generous service, and work well done." What are they going to say about your book? What will the world say about your own book? That you are wicked, vengeful, horrible, or what? Cursing, katakata, wherever you are. Instead of mitigating peace and much more. Beloved people of God, when the great and final judgment will come, each one of us will be asked 5 questions. Number one, what did you accomplish in the world with the power that God gave you? Even as an artist, I'm calling Njomi Ete, Nitumoko Omaraye, to change the hearts of people. If you're an actor or an actress, are you portraying the right things before all and sundry? Number two, how did you help your neighbors and what did you do for those who are in need? Look at Nigeria now, so many people are suffering. You see people picking for drone skins. What are you doing to alleviate their poverty? Number three, what did you do to serve God? Shakura and Shami. Look at the sacrifice. We are called to honor your husband, the choir, the priests, all those who have made this possible. What have you done to honor God? Number four, what did you leave in the world that was worth more than when you came into it? Just grab it, as if there is no tomorrow. Last but not least, what did you bring into this new world, which will be of use here? What have you brought? When a loved one like Dudu transits into the great beyond, the questions are, where are you going? Why? How long? What happens to us now? It is for us to keep eternity in view. It is for us to remember that we must live our lives closely for God. Must continue to live on. A foundation must be effected in the memory of his times with us. Are you with me? That foundation. He was a good man. How will you be remembered when you're gone? When you ask yourself this question, what is your response? Will others see it as selfish, uncommitted, loving, kind, giving, and more? The choice you make now will impact how others see you. We have to live in time, imprisoned by our limitations. As we are still fighting the battle of life, we have the opportunity of mending our ways, especially with all that is happening in Nigeria. There is still the time of amendment, as Prince will say. The position you hold in life, you hold it in trust, peradventure you are in government, or you are in a position of authority, you are better watch it. Watch it. There's no better time for us to speak the truth as Nigerians than now. The opportunity, the affluence, and the influence you have now, you hold it in trust, and so you better use it to make a difference. Whether you like it or not, you cannot live forever. Psalm 112 verse 6 talks about eternity and the right of being in everlasting remembrance. And it is a word of comfort to all of us. So, family members, wives, children, grandchildren, I want you to rise up, to walk, to pray, to give thanks to God, and to continue to worship God in the memory of your departed one. And I pray that God will give you the grace, the health, and constant companionship to lead you to success. you are comforted in remembering that you are going to see Tugu again. And I pray that God will console you. Jesus is standing today with open arms and is saying the same to you. Just go to Jesus. It's an encouragement you need as you move on in life. Turn all your sorrows over to Jesus Christ. Today, and courage for tomorrow. And the extended family members, and for ourselves as a church, not only to be comforted, but to be blessed with courage and the capacity for that passion, we must not take off for the family. For the assurance of God's comforting and abiding presence to overwhelm us. The Lucas and all of us, God will grant us the rest, the comfort and the grace and the courage we need. And I pray that as we turn over all our sorrows to Jesus, He will see us safely through. In Jesus' name. Father, we ask that the words which we have heard this day with our outward ears, may through your grace be so grafted inwardly in our hearts that it may bring forth in us the fruit of good living. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Thank you.
shall be seated on me as you attend your prayer. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Tell us,
your Father, the Lord, give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, be merciful to all travelers, especially those who have traveled from far and near places to commiserate with the bereaved and grant them safe return. Bless, guide, and defend them. Protect them from all dangers and perils of the road. Prosper them in their cause, that they, beholding your mercy and praising you for your goodness here, may the more be quickened with a desire for the full enjoyment of their privileges as fellow citizens with the saints in your heavenly household, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In this troubled life, until the ship levies and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us safe lodging, our holy rest and peace at the last, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Beloved people of God, whilst we sit off our brother, Oladiran Isola Igboronke, we stand and render the hymn, and their prayers will be offered for them.
be the husband to the widow. To the children, when they are in need of guidance and fatherly care, be a father to them. Because they are to uphold the legacy that their father has left behind. Sickness and all the evils in this world, we continue to shelter them from this and continue to bless and abide with them all the days of their lives. As we ask through Christ our Lord.
Please sit. Woo!
On behalf of the family and the Godfrey community, we are sorry for the delay in Shanghai. Mr. Oladiro Ishola, Ibirunke, you are dust. And dust shall be the town. May you rest in perfect peace.
Amen.
What is your name here?
Thank you. The children?
It's coming.
Thank you.
Next.
May the soul of our father, brother and friend, okay? And may the soul of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God,
rest in peace.
So they will do the other filling of the graveyard and they will cover it. Once again, thank you and God bless you all.
Sleep on.
Oh. Thank you, sir.
Oh,
okay, calm down.
I'm going to go to the camera. I'm going to go to the camera.